Hi, this is Michel Birler. In this video, I would like to show you how to prepare data to be used in Biogeme for the estimation of parameters of a choice model. I will use an example with the Swiss Metro dataset that is available directly from the Biogeme webpage. The first thing I will do is to look at the file itself. What are the data that are contained in this file? So let's open a notebook. And the first thing we need to do is to import Panda. It is custom to rename Panda as PD, so it's a shortcut for the use of Panda. And then we can open the data in a data frame. The data file that is available is in CSV format. It stands for comma separated values. Well, the values do not have to be separated by a comma. In this case, actually, they are separated by a tab. So therefore, we import the data frame by doing read CSV, so for comma separated values. We give the name of the file, and we specify which is the separation character. In this case, as I mentioned, this is the tab, which is represented by backslash t in Python. Good, so now we can display the content on the file. So what you see, it's a data frame that contains 10,728 rows and 28 columns. So each column corresponds to a variable that we want to use in our model specification. And each row corresponds to one observation that we will use for the estimation of our model. It is critical that all these values are numeric. So we cannot use any alphanumeric or strings or Boolean or things like this. So everything must be numeric in order to be used in Biogeme. When we will need to write the model specification, we will need to specify the name of the variables in the model specification. And the way to do this is by using a Biogeme expression called variable. So we can import it from the Biogeme expression. And it's called variable. So for example, the column choice that contains the variable called choice, well, is referred to by using the statement variable choice. Okay, so this is the choice variable. So it's convenient in order to include it into the model specification, in order to avoid to write all these statements, to specify a Python variable called choice as well, that we set to this value here, variable choice. And it's actually a good idea to do it for all the variables that are available in the data file. Well, of course, it can be quite tedious to write down all these statements. Therefore, I will show you a simple trick so that you can actually recuperate these statements automatically. The trick is based on simply a loop on the column names of the data frame. So I will loop for col in df.columns. And then I will print the statement above for each of these columns. So print, I use the formatted print, which is started by F in Python. And then it will be the name of the column, and then variable, and again, the name of the column. And as you can see, this simple loop has generated all the statements that I would need to use in order to access the variables from the file. So what I will do, I will copy these statements and I will save them into a file. And then I will import this file in my model specification script so that I have direct access to the variables in my data file. So let's now use the IDLE environment. We'll open a new file. I will save it on the desktop. I will call it swissmetro_data.py. and I will pass these statements into this file. Of course, I will have to put in this file the same statements that I have used in my Jupyter notebook so that it is correctly done. So I have to import panda as pd. I have to import the variable expression, and I will also import the database module from Biogeme. And I will call it DB in this case. Great, then I read the data, df equals pd.readcsv. This is the same statement that we have used before in the Jupyter notebook. SwissMetro.dat, and the separation is equal to / t. And now I can create the Biogeme database itself, database, using the DB module. So I give it a name called SwissMetro, let's say, and I provide a data frame that has been just read. Great, so this is basically the definition that you need to do in order to be able to use the data from your data file into Biogeme. But there is more that you may want to do as data preparation before you start specifying the model. The first thing may be to exclude some data from the file because you don't want or you don't need them for the specific types of models that you will be estimating. And in order to do that, you will have to define an exclude condition. And for the sake of the example in this SwissMetro case study, I would like to keep only the observations for people traveling with a trip purpose, which is either commuter or business. And if you look at the documentation of the data, which is available online, you will see that this corresponds to people who have a purpose equals 1 and a purpose equals 3. So these are the one I want to keep. So the one I want to exclude should be purpose different than 1 and purpose different than 3. So I want to exclude these two. In Biogeme, the result of any calculation is always numerical. And when you need to work with Boolean, the convention is that the value false is equal to 0 and the value true is equal to 1. So therefore, when you want to model an and, like here, we would like to model purpose different than 1 and purpose different than 3, well, we will use a multiplication like this to represent the and operation. So this will define my exclude statement for the purpose. I will also need to clean the data because some of the variables have not been coded properly. For example, there are some observations for which the value of the choice is equal to 0, which does not correspond to any valid alternative. So I would like to also exclude those alternatives for which choice equals 0. So now my complete exclude statement should be exclude for the reason of the purpose or exclude for the reason of the choice. And again, when we used the multiplication to model an and, we will use an addition, a plus, to model an or. And to make sure that we will obtain something which is consistent with the Boolean, we will say, well, we'll exclude an observation if this quantity is strictly positive. Great, so this is the condition that will identify those observations for which the purpose is not 1 and not 3, or for which the choice is equal to 0, or both, actually. And in order to remove all these observations from the database, we simply type database dot remove, and then we provide this condition that we have just defined. And then the last thing we may want to do is to define new variables which are not directly available from the file, but that can be calculated from variables from the file. Well, let's take an example. So the variable train CO, which is defined here, represents the cost of the train, the cost of the ticket for the travel by train. But several individuals own a yearly pass, meaning that they pay a flat fee for the year, and then they will not have to buy any ticket anymore. So for these people, the perceived cost of taking the train for a specific trip is zero. And these people are identified by this variable here, GA, which stands for the German name Generalabonnement, which means the yearly pass. Therefore, for these people, we would like to make sure that the actual cost for the train is equal to zero. And to do this, we will redefine a new variable that I will call train cost, spelled out COST. And I will include in the database a new variable that I will define like this. I define the variable. I provide the name, so it is extremely useful to use the exact same name as the variable that we have defined before. And then I provide the definition. So this is the train CO, which is available already in the data file, multiplied by the fact that the GA is equal to zero. If GA is equal to zero, it means that the person does not have a yearly pass, so this will be one, and therefore the train cost would be equal to train CO. If the person owns a yearly pass, this quantity would be equal to zero. And then we can close the parentheses. I can use the same definition for the Swiss Metro. This is what I've done here. Okay. And then I can also rescale the variable. So it's always a good idea to change the scale of the variable, so to avoid having large numbers in the database. So in this case, I can, for example, decide that the train travel time that I will scale down, so I will call it TT scaled, would be defined as follows. So this will be again train TT scale. This value here will be the name of the column in the database, and again I'm using the same name as the Python variable, and I will define it as train TT divided by 100, for example. Okay, and then of course I can do this for several variables available in the data, like this. I will add some space so that we read it better. And finally, to be complete, I will also define two new variables which define the availability of the car and the train alternatives for stated preference observation. So again, the syntax is the same. So you provide the name of the new column, and then you provide the formula for the calculation of the values of this new column. Great. So this is it. So my data is now prepared, and all these quantities that I have defined in this file, so that I have called this Swiss Metro underscore data, can now be imported in my script for the model specification, so that I can use them in the model that I want to estimate. Let's check that it's working. Let's import this train TT scale that I have just defined. So from Swiss Metro data, import train TT scaled. And we can check that train TT scale is now well defined. Yes, it is well defined. We can also import the database itself. Database. And we can see what are the data contained in the database. And here you can see that the number of rows is 6,768 rows. Why? Because we have removed from the database several rows that do not correspond to what we want. Remember, the trip purpose different from one and different from three, and when the choice is equal to zero. You can also see that this database now contains the additional columns that we have calculated that were not available in the original file. And you can verify, for example, that the choice we can look at the unique values of this column. Well, the choice can take three values, 1, 2, and 3, which is exactly what we want in this case. Great, so this concludes this video. You know how to prepare the file SwissMetros_data, where basically you store everything you need to do for the preparation of your data before you can use them for the model specification.